basis of their conclusions is simply flawed. This is the it's the kind of evidence that courts have traditionally gay stuff is coming in. Alright? So, we've got to deal with it. We've got to turn this into a challenge to the people. We don't know whether it's coming or not. So, we have to do it. These are the reasons why you like to get into that. Because then we'll talk about that. Then, when it doesn't come in, you look like a hero. You look like you're real smart. For sure.
Thank you. lot of broken glass.
Yeah, that's all I want. You know, and then the next.
Thank you.
All right, Chris, we're going to see if you can hear us upstairs now.
They didn't find any murder weapon. Nothing. Where did it go? Where did this blood poker go? They searched his car. There wasn't any blood in the car. They went all around the house. There wasn't any blood upstairs. They didn't change his clothes. They didn't... Where did he get rid of it? And when? That's left mysterious. But we don't convict people based on mysterious. I mean, can you imagine somebody beating somebody over the head? You don't whack somebody like this when you're trying to kill them. Imagine that there's no skull fracture. There's no brain contusion. There's no swelling of the brain. There's no internal hemorrhages, subdurals, things like that that you would see in that kind of injury.
Sitting on Michael's lap. And what you see there is the happiness that she felt with him and that he felt with her. Everyone who really knew that relationship, everyone who knew them, knew that they loved each other. Everyone who knew them knows that Michael Peterson had nothing to do with the death of Kathleen Peterson.